The video is about an often ignored, but crucial setting in FPS games, anisotropic filtering. Hello, I'm Masakari, a German blogger, FPS coach, and former pro gamer. With over 50,000 hours in FPS games, and over 35 years of FPS gaming, including over 20 years in the competitive scene of Counter-Strike, PUBG, and Valorant under my belt, I would love to share my knowledge with you. There might be a deeper dive into the topic for your game on my blog. Just check the links in the description of this video. Give the video a thumbs up now, or later, if you want to see more videos like this. Here we go. Should I use anisotropic filtering for FPS games? Of course, the correct settings don't make you a superstar. It's your talent, your skills, and your experience that do, but the thought that my system is running optimally, and therefore it depends solely on my abilities, and those of the opponent, has always given me a better feeling, and more self-confidence, because everything that can positively influence my performance, I have done, and I knew that I am therefore hard to beat. Anisotropic filtering is a technique used in video games, to improve image quality. What is anisotropic filtering in the context of gaming? First of all, it must be said that there are two ways to set the anisotropic filtering, in the NVIDIA control panel, or in the in-game menu. The default setting in the NVIDIA control panel is application controlled. Thus, the in-game settings take effect, and most games, especially FPS games, have the corresponding setting options. Anisotropic filtering has to do with the textures, making an item more realistic in the gaming experience. However, textures have an issue, that if no filtering is applied to them, the closer objects look great, but the ones in the distance don't follow this pattern. Anisotropic filtering is a more advanced mode of filtering than bilinear and trilinear filtering, because this mode reduces the aliasing within textures. As a result, distant objects seem much more high quality, particularly when viewed at extreme angles. For example, if you are enjoying a flight simulator experience, AF will assist in making the distant part of the runway appear clearer, while landing the plane. Depending upon your hardware, you might or might not be able to feel the drop in frame rates, but higher values of video memory are used when AF is enabled as compared to when it isn't. So, in simple words, and to summarize anisotropic filtering in the context of gaming, without the AF feature enabled in games, distant items appear blurry. Still, when you increase the value of AF, they become clearer. How much does anisotropic filtering affect performance in FPS games? It is vital to have a clear image of other players that are not just located close to you, but of those as well that are located far away. This can have a significant impact on how you participate in the game. If AF is turned on, the player's performance is usually much better than the case in which it is turned off. Of course, turning on AF doesn't mean that it will improve your performance and suddenly win all your games. But it can help in some games with long distances. Does anisotropic filtering cause input lag in FPS games? Anisotropic filtering is a resource-hungry process. It is a guzzler when it comes to using GPU memory. If the hardware setup has limited VRAM, the input lag will increase as you increase the AF settings. The latency might mean the difference between winning your sessions or losing them altogether. It is also pertinent to mention that the input lag due to AF depends directly upon the setting of anisotropic filtering selected by a player. Anisotropic filtering is not nearly as resource-consuming as anti-aliasing, for example, and if you have a good graphics card, it won't cause any seriously noticeable input lag. Which anisotropic filtering is best for FPS games? To know which anisotropic filtering is best for FPS games, we first need to know the common AF options that gaming titles provide to players. There are commonly four such options, which are 2x, 4x, 8x, and 16x. There is no hard and fast rule as to which value of anisotropic filtering is the best for first-person shooter games. While it is true that the higher the value of AF is, the better is the image quality. However, it would be an overstatement to say that you can just beef up the value of AF to 16x, for getting the best results. It is also pertinent to mention that selecting the same value of AF for two different gaming titles will have different results. For example, if you choose the value of AF as 2x in Call of Duty and Valorant, you won't get the same results. So, in simple words, there is no single value of AF that can be termed as the best for all first-person shooter games, and it all comes down to the gaming title under consideration and the hardware in question. Final thoughts. In conclusion, in games with large distances, it can be useful to take a closer look at anisotropic filtering, provided that your system supports it. Unfortunately, as with almost all settings, you will have to make sacrifices with a weaker system. For example, in games like Valorant, where only melee combat is involved, and the graphics are very clean, anisotropic filtering won't make much of a difference. It may even lead to unnecessary input lag. But in games like Call of Duty, or PUBG, a test of the different settings is certainly appropriate for ambitious gamers. Thanks for watching, don't miss our next videos, and subscribe now. As always, happy fragging. My nickname is Masakari, Meep, Meepin' out.